This conference will now be recorded.
Hi, good evening everyone. Am I audible? Screen.
Hi, good evening. Yes, we can hear you.
Yeah. So today, I tried to avoid the confusion which we had yesterday. So I did some setup. So instead of asking you guys, you may not miss the concentration. So I made one setup like, so there is a Bitbucket server and we have developer one and developer two machines. I created in Google Cloud. So I will log into these machines as, consider this is developer one laptop, this is developer two laptop. And okay, and three users. So those users are, this one is the main user, which I have already the full access. And the developer one is write access, developer two also write access. So I created a project git practice here. You go and I will show you the permissions what I have given. So before that, I created one group. So you come here, settings and group. There is a group called developers. So here I added developer one and developer two. Okay. And to this git practice, I gave the project permissions to the developers group write access. So it means the developers inside this developer one and developer two will get the access for the projects, whatever I'm going to create in this folder. Okay. And I will open incognito for the developers web console. And this one. Okay. So is this clear till now about the setup? This is developer one laptop, this is developer two laptop. I have IP address, I will log in. Okay. So I'm logging in now. So this is the IP address. I'll take and log in here. So it's already logged in. This is developer one machine. This is developer two machine. So first thing, I need to install Git client. It means like Git bash. So let's log into the console. So you need to imagine carefully. So reflecting the real-time environment and teaching online is very difficult. Okay. So that's why I made this setup. So this is the view for developer one. So developer one is from the Internet Explorer and developer two is the incognito window of Google Chrome. Sorry, developer one is from Internet Explorer, developer two is from Google Chrome incognito. Okay. And these are their laptops. Fine. So now I will create one repository here. Hello world. talking about. Even you don't understand this setup, just think it like this. And I will show you the project permissions. This should be very clear. So developer one and developer two in this group, they have the project write access. Branch permissions, carefully look at this. So from so I restricted the access for development and master. So these two are our main branches, you know already. So master and development are our main branches. And then supporting branches will be feature, release, and hotfix. Just technically, these are all same, but the naming convention, so it is for ourselves only. So here you can see these conditions. I am restricting except me. He is the admin or architect or manager. Except me, so I am restricting everybody. Prevent changes without a pull request is restricted to the branch development. And normal users, like apart from admin, they cannot delete this branch. They cannot rewrite this history. So these are the permissions. These are the setup I have done it. Same similar for master also, because master is always pointing to the production. So I will restrict for the normal users like developers, team leaders. Only the architects may have this setup. You cannot delete master. You cannot changes. You cannot change into master without pull request. All this setup I have done. You can do the similar setup when you are working. And default reviewers. From any branch to the development branch, if you want to merge something with pull request, see here, add default reviewers for pull request. This is me. So if I approve only, you can merge your changes into the development branch or master branch. So these are the settings. These are the real-time settings what we follow in our projects, in our company or any company. Okay. So now I'll create a project. That's project is already created. And here I need to create some branches. There is no branch creation. Okay. So I will clone it and I will create it. So this git bash in Windows is for me. Git clone. Okay, it's already exist. I'm removing everything. So you need to carefully understand this. Otherwise, it's very difficult. Okay. So here, there is a master branch. So what I will do is, I will just create one sample file. So I'm creating the main branches. So these comments are very normal, you already know. Only I can do this because I am the administrator. Nobody cannot write to the master branch or development branch. This is the initial setup. Not doing any changes, just pushing it. Okay, so now two branches are created. Okay, so these two main branches are created. Now think developers are joined into our projects. Okay, he is the developer. He wants to clone this. So usually what he do, developer one is from Internet Explorer, right? So he will go here and so you need to switch yourself whenever I am doing something. You fix it. Developer one is from Internet Explorer, developer two is from Google Chrome incognito, and the administrator is from actual Google Chrome. So now developer one is cloning. Okay, he cloned it, and developer two also joined. He is also cloning. Okay. And now you can see WinSCP view of this. This is dev mission one. He got this project. This is WinSCP. Now developer one is doing the changes. This is a feature from developer one and he saved it. Now you can check the status. Oh, sorry, I have not created feature branch, right? Sorry. Okay, so from developer one mission, I moved into Spring Boot project. I'm into master now. I will check out development because you know the source and everything, right? Just refer this. I will share this document with you. For feature branches, source should be development, target should be development. So we will be working on the feature branches now. Git checkout. This is the naming notation, developer one, and this is from developer one, 1.1 feature, you can think of it. Sorry, I forgot hyphen B. Okay. So now I will do some changes here. From developer one. Now you come and check. That is modified. Git commit hyphen m. Change from developer one. Okay, so now This is the first time, right? Just config. Global user.email dev1@gmail.com. Now commit and push it. Feature dev1-1.1. Okay, so now you can see new feature branch is pushed to the central repository. You can see here. Feature dev 1.1. So this is the developer one change. So the same developer two will do like his own changes. He is creating new feature dev2-1.1 from development. Yeah, this is developer two mission. This is from dev two mission and save. Now you can check the status. Yeah, git add. Git, before that it will, you need to config --- global user.email dev2@gmail.com. Same username. Dev2 git commit and then git push. So when I'm writing something, just remember the commands and the flow. Okay, so now dev2 is also there. Okay, so now imagine dev1 completed his development and he wants to merge his changes into the development branch. So that is what our use case, right? So our use case says, so once whatever not use case, it's real time. So once you complete with your featured branches, once you complete your development in feature branches, you have to merge it to the master branch, development branch. So merge means incorporating your changes into the development branch. So, and I created a restriction. So whenever you want to push your changes from feature to development or main branches, you need to go by pull request. So developer one has to create a pull request. So this is developer one from Internet Explorer. So he has to come and create a pull request from his to development branch. And you can see the difference here. Okay. So this is the difference he made it. This feature is from development one. So this is the difference he made. Okay. And these are the commits he posted to the feature branch. And now go and continue. So the reviewer is me, like architect. So he will give one title. This is feature one and some description. Raising this too much feature one into dev branch, and he will create it. So now that notification will come to my dashboard. See, you can see here, this is feature one. There is a pull request for me. So now you can see developer one created this pull request. The description is raising his branch into the development branch. I will see the difference what he made from the earlier files. And then if everything is okay to me, I will approve. Otherwise, I'll write some comments. He has to again do some changes and push the changes to the feature branch. So this pull request will be automatically updated. So this changes looks fine to me. I will click on approve. So then he go and check. So this pull request is approved. Now he can merge. So remember the limitation I set. You cannot merge into development branch without raising pull request. And you can delete the feature branch now. Okay, just to merge. See, it is merged. Now you go and check the branching tree. You can see here, developer one created one branch, again merged it into the development branch. Now you can see there is a merge commit created automatically. The description is also automatically merge pull request from feature. So with this log, you can see in your future, maybe after 10-15 days, what happened with all these changes. You can come and see here clearly. Developer one created one branch, he merged here, and this is the merge commit. Okay, so clear. So development branch moved ahead, and developer two is still working on. Maybe he will do some other commits. He's taking some more time. This is another line from dev two. And he will push those changes. And now he consider his development is over. Now he will come and he wants to raise pull request. So create pull request from his branch to development branch. And he did two commits. And the difference, you can see, this is the difference. Now you go and click on continue. It is giving warning. This pull request cannot be merged. You will need to resolve conflicts to be able to merge. See, it is telling because it compared. Development branch moved ahead. You are raising pull request. It is giving some warnings. If you go and check here difference, these are the conflicts it is showing. Okay. Because Git founds different content in the same line while merging. Okay. So now it is our responsibility to resolve the merge conflicts and merge into the development branch. So how do you resolve? First, go to your workspace. I'll just write the commands. Go to your workspace and check out development branch and pull the changes and check out your feature branch and merge your development branch. Then you will get the conflicts you should resolve. So let us go to the developer 2. He should check out to the development branch. He need to pull the changes. He got the changes and then he will check out his feature branch. And he will write this command git merge development. So now it is saying merge conflict in hello world.txt. So we need to resolve that merge conflict. Okay, so let us. I'll open in this developer 2 mission. Okay, so this is the conflict. So this is where the conflict starts and this is where it ends. From head to here in this block, these are your changes, and from this equal to this right side arrow, these are developer 1 changes. Here it is, it got the conflict. So now you go to the developer 1, you both sit together and you will need to decide what to keep. So you both decided you need to keep both code. Then you will just remove these lines. Save it. Now you check the status. Like normally, you do one commit. Resolving conflicts. And then you push. Okay, so now you come and refresh this pull request. It automatically updated. Now there is no warning of merge conflicts because we resolve the conflicts. We sit with developer 2, we sit with developer 1, I mean developer 2 sit with developer 1, and then he resolved the conflicts. Now everything is fine. Now I admin or architect, he will go here and he would have got one notification. This is from developer 2, and he will review the difference with what he did. Okay, so this is the difference. In red color, he deleted these lines. This is adding. Okay, and then he will click on approve. The developer 2 come to know this. My code got approved, and then I will merge it. You can remove this feature branch when you are going for merge. Okay. So this is merge. Now, if you go and check the development branch, so we got all the changes from developer 1 and developer 2. Now you check the commits. So this is showing you very clearly. Here developer 1 started and he merged it here. Here developer 2 started. He resolved some conflicts here. See here, he resolved some conflicts and he merged it. Okay, so whenever you merge, you will get one commit ID, extra commit ID, and the symbol you can see, M, special commit it is. Okay, so now consider all developers completed their features and they merged it into the development branch. So now what is the branching strategy? If you remember, see this diagram, you need to understand how to see this diagram in Git. So from master, first I created master and then development from master, and here developer 1, developer 2 did some commits and they merged it into the development branch. Now release branch should come from development branch. Okay, so maybe I go like architect, will go here. And there are some changes. Okay, first thing, I need to pull the changes. Git pull origin. Development. Okay, so now I got the changes, because okay, here you can see the changes. Now you create release branch. Release, maybe this is 1.1 release out of development. Okay, and then you push to the central repository. Okay, so now the release branch is pushed to the central repository. So whenever a release branch is created, it means all the development is completed. It should be tested in SIT and UIT environments. So testing team will do all those testings and they found some defects. So those defects needs to be addressed. So who has to fix those defects? Developers has to address those defects. So first thing, they have to pull. Okay, so ignore this information. Here you can see new branch release 1 is pulled. Similarly, here also you do pull. You can see new branch release is pulled out. So now there are some defects. Developer one, if you see the tree, the release branch may get some defects in SIT and UAT. Those should be minor defects only. Major defects, you cannot fix it here. Developer one and developer two will be fixing those defects in the release branch itself. Here the difference is, you should understand, in the feature development, every developer has their own feature branch. But in release branch, you have to fix minor defects. Every one of you should work on the same branch. Okay. So now it is there is some defect. Developer one has to fix it. First, he will check out to the release branch. Switch it to new branch, and then he should open that file. Go to developer one mission. Okay. This line says a bug fix from developer one. And he saved it and check the status. And he's adding it. Bug fix from developer one. And he need to push this. Okay, so now release branch more little forward. Okay, so this is the release branch. You can see the commits. Developer one did some commit on the release branch. So developer two also should pull that usually. Git checkout release 1.1. He will pull it. Why he is pulling? If there are some defects needs to be addressed by developer two, he has to do this. Okay. So now consider release branches, bugs are fixed. So now what is the process? From release branch, you should do the merge to the master branch. Okay. So how will you do the master branch? Merging, you should go by pull request only. Maybe developer one has to create some pull request from release branch, because this is production release. So whenever you push the code from release to master branch, it is called as production release. So just before the production release, we will do this. So these are all the commits he is pushing to the master, and you can see the difference. See, this is the only one line when I created into master. All these code we are adding it, and this is well tested in SIT and UAT. So now there is the you are sure the code is working properly, and you are going for production release. Now you click on continue, rising a pull request. Who has to approve? Architect has to approve. Just write some code is working fine. We can go for prod release. and here they will attach some files about the test results. Like we have done test cases, and you can see here test cases results. They will attach some files as a proof. Now, architect. So architect will come, our team manager, some release manager, or that whoever responsible for the release. And he will get the notification. He will open this pull request, and he will attach. He will download those files, and he will check everything is working fine, testing is done properly, and if he can go for code review everything, and he gives approval. So then it is approved. Our developer one is doing the production release, for example. So when he merge it, a new commit will be created and pushed onto the master branch. Okay. You have. Okay. So see, it is I restricted developers to do the production release. Okay. Maybe I'll give access to the DevOps guys for the production release. So now, for example, since we don't have DevOps team, maybe the manager is doing the merge also into the master. Okay, because you remember I made that setting. Now I'm clicking on merge. But you should not delete this branch. Why? Because if this is successful, you need to pull these changes into the development branch as well. You can see here, if this is successful, you need to pull this branch into the development branch also, because I did some bug fixes here. Okay. And you can see the difference, minor bug fixes here, major bug fixes from here to development, again from here to feature. So you can say in the interviews, release branch is only for minor bug fixes. If there are any major bug fixes found, they have to create the feature branches, and they have to start the process from the first. Now you come here, you don't delete release branch, and you do the master branch. So whenever it is merged, you can see a new commit is created on the master branch. See, merge pull request from release to master. What? So how we do the automated CI/CD deployments, production deployments, is we will push an event to the Jenkins if there is any new commit comes to the master branch. So this is the new commit into the master branch. Then Jenkins will fetch this commit ID, and then it will do the production release, automatic CI/CD DevOps deployments. The event is whenever you merge something into the master branch, it will create one commit ID. So with that, we will trigger the production deployment. This is automation, but earlier world scenarios, we were doing the deployments manually. Okay, so now consider the production deployment is successful. Now, the major thing you have to do is you need to tag it. Git checkout master. Pull it. So you got the changes and the deployment is successful. Now you need to do the tagging. So what is tagging? Tagging is just a label. For example, if you have 1,000 covers in your home, maybe from different shopping malls, without anything on the cover. For example, plain covers, you have 1,000 in your home from different shopping malls. So how will you define this is from more, this is from Reliance, like that? So generally, we can have just a label attached to that cover. This is more, this is like that. So we have a lot of commits in the history. But in future, if you want to come and see what are the releases happened, then you cannot remember these commit IDs, right? So that's why we have something called tag. So you can see the log. So this is, I want to tag this commit with some name so that in future I can easily remember it. Okay. So now the command is git tag hyphen a and the tag name. So we can call this as a release. Okay, we can call this as 1.1. Just like in Android, if you see 12 point version, 13 point version, 14 point version, that is how they release. Similarly, we also release git tag hyphen a 1.1. So what will happen is this commit will be tagged with 1.1. So you will write some message here. This is the release 1.1 happened successfully, something like this. Now you need to push the tag, git push origin. What is your tag? 1.1. So pushing the branch name and pushing the tag both are same. Git push origin branch name usually. Instead of that, we can have git push origin and the tag name you created. So this new tag is pushed to the remote repository. Now you come here and refresh. You can see the tag 1.1 is attached to this release, production release. See here the symbol also like label. So after 3 or 4 releases, you can come and check which commit we pushed into the production. Okay. So we tagged it, and something else pending. You need to merge your release branch also into the development branch. Maybe developer go and create a pull request from release to development branch. So this is the difference, and he will click on continue merging the successful changes. Oh, sorry. Is it pulled? Everything is pulled, right? Developer one. Yeah, so we need to pull these tags also. So everything, when somebody is pushing, all other developers should pull. Okay, I will also pull just to keep myself updated. This is the common practice. Before you push something, you need to pull. So here also I got the tags. You can see the log. Okay, so this is the one, release 1.1. Okay. And then, so now the task is to create the pull request. First I'll check the file. Yeah, I think it's fine. So now here I'll create the pull request from release 1.1 to the development. successful request to merge the successful release into development. Just change the title. And create it. Okay, so now the team leader or team manager, he will come. And he will check the difference, everything, and he will click on approve. And then we'll click on merge. Now you can remove this release branch. Okay, so that's how our entire process. Now you come and see your development branch is up to date. Now we can work for next releases. Okay, now you can ask your doubts. So there will be lot of doubts coming in your minds. So until you practice, you cannot visualize, or your imagination is very difficult. So I tried my best to reflect the real-time environment from a single laptop. So more than this, it's impossible to show like this. Any doubts? You can unmute yourself and ask.
Sure, we have deleted our feature branches and release branches in central repository, right? So after that, yes. if we pull the changes, so in our local also, it need to be deleted, or it will be exist?
You can delete, or if it exists, also not a problem. It's in your local only, right?
It's in my local. Then how come developer come to know whether it is merged or not?
So usually we delete the feature branches. Otherwise, the load on the Bitbucket server will be more and more. Still, when you check out the same feature branch, which is deleted in the remote repository, and if you push again from that branch, Bitbucket will understand that is a new feature branch.
So if you log into the developer one system and if you check for the branches, it will be present and the data will be same inside that features. Then how come developer come to know whether the future one branches second, is merged with the?
Once again.
Yeah, you can log once into again. The developer one. Yes. Okay.
Yeah, I will log into the developer one. So I already logged in.
Okay, you can check for the branches. It will be there, and the content also no. Same inside that.
No, it's not there.
Is it?
Yeah. At the time of merging, I deleted. Whoever doing is merge, he will.
Yeah,
delete it
is in central server. It is deleted, but I'm saying in developer and Git bash.
Yeah, in developer Git bash, it will be there. Actually, you have to delete it. You are the one who did the merge, right? You are the one who clicked on delete the feature branch. Then you should delete your branch in your local. If you don't delete also, it's not a problem. Whenever you are doing the next feature development, you will create another branch from the development branch, like feature slash 1.2.
Okay.
So even you have that branch, not a problem.
Okay, for example, if developer one requested for a pull and he merged it, but developer two is not aware of this, but after vacation he came, developer two came, and he started working. So how can developer two came to know whether this is merged or not?
He don't care about that feature branch. He care about only his branch.
Okay. So if developer two is working on his particular branch,
Yes, developer two is working on his particular branch. All the time he is worry about his code. But when he is going for the pull request, Git will show you your code is conflicted with this person or something, or this commit.
So in this case, each developer need to maintain their own branch.
That is the best strategy. That is the best strategy.
So in real time also this?
In real time also. So whenever your maybe developers get some tasks from the team leaders, they will create a Jira ticket. They will create a Jira ticket. So each Jira ticket can have one branch. Like each single piece of code change can be created with some different feature branch.
Okay, fine. Thanks.
But if multiple developers work on the same feature branch, that's managing is very difficult. For example, I will tell you. The feature branch, I told, one developer works on one feature branch. But when it comes to the release branch, so why I told only minor fixes should be done here? Because it is a shared. It is shared between, for example, five developers are working. If there is a small defect, it is shared. Maybe two developers has to fix. What will happen? Developer one will fix something, and he will push the changes to the release branch, and the developer two has to pull the changes, and then he push. So I told you, the developer one did some defect fixing and pushed it to the release branch. Parallelly, developer two also doing some code changes. When he is pushing, Git will not allow.
Because
his branch moved ahead. Then he has to pull the changes. So this will only work for minor bug fixes. If there are major bug fixes, this will not work. Okay. That's why it is only minor bug fixes.
Okay, thanks.
So hotfix, similar way, you can just read this description. This like just like one of the feature branch, you derive it from the master and merge it to the master as well as development. So this is the first question, even for developers, testers or DevOps guys, what is the branching strategy? If they want to really test your design skills. So you can think of lot of use cases. If there is a one big feature, there is only one feature branch. Five developers are working on one feature branch. How to manage that? Yeah, we can use SSH instead of using credentials. Okay, so till today we have we spoke about the merge and branching strategy, everything. Then tomorrow class we will speak about rebase, when to use merge and when to use rebase, and then after that we will discuss the advanced branching strategy for rapid development. So this works for mostly waterfall and agile models, but this will never work for DevOps related model like what big companies are doing, vigorous production releases. Okay, we can discuss the disadvantages of this in tomorrow's session. So that's all for today. If you have any doubts, you can ask, otherwise we can wind up. I think we can wind up. Good night. Have a nice day.
Yeah, thanks for that session.
Thank you.
Thank you for the session.
Thank you.